Yes, children, good morning. So Ranga's marriage we had already been doing. So we have already read out, like the writer talks about, like how this place where Ranga lives, how that village is very important. Basically, the fact is like a native place is dear to all. That's a fact. We always love our own motherland, the place where we are born, that is always dear to us. And each place has its own specialities. But and this writer is also able to find out something unique about his village. Maybe the raw, the kind of raw mango, or the kind of, you know, the dishes they have. So these things are, you know, just you can say like something the writer is very fond of, because he, for everybody, one's motherland is important or dear. Then the writer introduces us to the protagonist of the story, that is Ranga, the one who had gone to the city to get higher education. And when he comes back after having been, educated, and after having become educated, plus the one who knows English, then the villagers are apprehensive, like maybe Ranga might have changed. Okay, the whole village comes and, examines him, and they are of the view that Ranga has not changed. So there we were able to make out that Ranga was the same respectful, well-mannered and a cultured boy. So he had not changed over these years. But let's see whether the narrator is also able to have the same view. Will he find that Ranga is the same? So here we will see a little shift in the story, because we will see that Ranga might have changed ideologically. His ideology or outlook about life might have changed. It has changed. He thinks a bit differently now. But we will also find side by side, is that ideology actually changed? Or is it only, influenced by the external environment? Whatever we talk about the external environment or influences, our roots are never forgotten, mind it. That is this chapter is about. Okay, we may say that we might have adopted Western culture, we might try to become very modern, but in the end, we are deep rooted with our culture. We may not accept it, but that happens to be a fact. And the mature people don't, feel bad about accepting it. The problem is only with the youngsters. They tend to show off that yes, they are modern, their ideology or thinking has changed, but actually it doesn't change. That is what the story is about. So Ranga will not agree with the proposal as put forward by the narrator for him, because he will be of the opinion that why will he marry a girl, the one whom he doesn't know? But in the end, he will marry that very girl whom he had never seen, whom he did not know. And yes, the best part was that he had a very happy married life with her. Why was it so? Because the one who proposed this match for him, that person knew, that mature person, that elderly person knew that what kind of match will be suitable for this boy. Got it? So here in this chapter, you can say there is an underlying importance of the viewpoint or the wisdom of the elderly and mature people. Got it? So let's see now. So we were on page number... Okay, page number 18. Last paragraph, page number 18. Once they realize that, Once they realize that Ranga still had the same hands, legs, eyes, and nose, the crowd melted away like a lump of sugar. This we had done. So finally, the crowd, dissipated, because they got to know that Ranga had not changed. So they were satisfied. So they all went off. So he came near me and did a namaskara respectfully, saying, I'm all right with your blessings. So narrator was wished or was greeted respectfully by the boy, that is Ranga. I must draw your attention to this aspect of Ranga's character. He knew when it would be to his advantage to talk to someone and rightly assess people's worth. So narrator says that I must tell you this quality of Ranga, that he knew whom to talk at the right moment. And moreover, Ranga was able to assess people's worth. Ranga knew that it is very important to talk to narrator, because the narrator was known to be he might have the reputation of being a very wise person. When you know that somebody is wise, you must give due respect to him or her more than what you give to the other common people. There is an example for you people here. Supposing there are 50 friends of yours in one party. All of a sudden, your teacher goes there also. Teacher also comes, maybe uninvited, by chance. Though you have not invited that person, the one who has come uninvited, but that teacher, being wise, being mature, being your mentor, deserves respect. I gave you an example of teacher. It might be your uncle. It might be your grandfather. Amidst your 50 friends, your grandfather comes uninvited. But you must give him that due respect and regard which that person deserves because of his age, wisdom, and the kind of role he plays in your life. Okay, so this is called your maturity. When you give due respect to the person of that worth, then that person doesn't get anything extra, but you only get that. Yes, you become, you show that you are equally wise. You gain something. Okay, as for this namaskara to me, he did not do it like any present day boy, with his head up towards the sun, standing stiff like a pole without joints, jerking his body as if it was either a wand or walking stick. Nor did he merely fold his hands. He bent low to touch my feet. May you get married soon, I said, blessing him. After exchanging a few pleasantries, I left. So what's the narrator telling us? That the way this boy wished me, that was not like other youngsters. It's not that he just touched my feet, thereby being standing like a pole. He actually touched his feet with due respect, manners. He did this. And he says that after, then the narrator also blessed him with, what was the blessing? May you get married soon. So whenever a child becomes marriageable, after having become financially, emotionally, intellectually independent, then one should get married off. That is a social, that is a social responsibility. Not only of the elders, but also of the youngsters. Okay. So after exchanging a few pleasantries, I left. What does it mean that after exchanging a few pleasantries? So after having discussed a few here and a few things about here and there, all is well, yes, how is he doing this, that. So very common things after very common interaction, they left. Narrator left. That afternoon when I was resting, Ranga came to my house with a couple of oranges in his hand. Got it? That afternoon when I was resting. So afterwards I went home. Then in the afternoon, Ranga came to narrator's house with a few oranges in his hands. A generous, considerate fellow. So considerate means caring. It would be a fine thing to have him marry, settle down and be of service to society, I thought. So when he came to narrator's house with something to offer him, the narrator found was of the, like he, felt that this boy was actually very generous and very caring. It was if Ranga went to narrator's house in the afternoon with something to give him, maybe oranges. The point is that it shows that he wanted to meet him personally. That's it. And there is nothing, nothing selfish about his meeting him. It's only a gesture of respecting somebody, the one who is very respectable and the one who is very wise. That's only his gesture of being caring and wise. Okay. So the narrator thought like this kind of good boy should marry now. Why? Because he was already financially independent. Intellectually, he was already And finally, basically, he was a very wise boy. And these kinds of children should get married off at the right age. So for a while, we talked about this and that. Then I came to the point, Rangappa, when do you plan to get married? So narrator came to the point finally. Got it? Why not? I'm going to, so Rangappa, he asked Rangappa, when do you plan to get married? Now see the answer of Ranga. Ranga said, I am not going to get married now, he said. Why not? I need to find the right girl. I know an officer who got married only 6 months ago. He's about 30 and his wife is 25, I am told. They will be able to talk lovingly to each other. Let's say I married. So up till here, what does Rangappa say? That he will not marry yet. Because he still has to find a suitable girl. Got it? So there is now a change in opinion. Narrator expected him to marry, go for an arranged marriage. But Rangappa now is telling him that he will not marry the girl yet. Because he has to find a suitable girl. And then he gives an example of his officer who is 30 and his wife is 25 and they are doing well. What does he actually want to say through this example? Aryaman, what does Rangappa want to say through this example? No, right now he says that I know an officer who is 30 years old and his wife is 25 years old and they are doing well. So what does he want to say through this? Age. He wants to point out that yes, he will marry a little bit later on. Not yet. Because he thinks that he says his idea is the maturer you are. He wants to basically says that if you get married off late, then you are able to adjust better in your life because by that time you become mature and wise. But you people know that in our olden times, before at the times of your grandparents, people used to get married off very early. And girls would be hardly 18 and boys would be hardly 21 when they would get married off. Did they ever go for divorce? How many of them used to go for divorces? How many of you of them go for separation? Not out of thousands, I guess, not even one, even then. Then they're used, and then people would have a very happy families also. But now the children are more educated. They are earning more than what used to be the earnings earlier. Even then now, and now children think that we are very intelligent. We can take our own decision. And eventually what happens? The marriages break after 1 or 2 or 3 years. And some marriages break even after 5-15 years. There happens to be no understanding because the decision of getting married, you know, it's not only about marrying one boy and another girl. It's actually the harmony of two families, two cultures. Okay, so many things can be taken into account, which only the elderly people like narrator can see. Okay, so right now Rangappa flatly refused. And his ideology about refusing about marriage was that he's too young. And he will marry a little later so that, and moreover, he will marry a maturer girl. The one who should be about 25 or something so that that girl adjusts with me. So that there is an understanding. And when there is understanding, and it is sometimes even between a person who is 50 and somebody who is 16. And when there is no understanding, it cannot be even between two friends. Getting understanding is a matter of your own acceptance. Sometimes we have to accept something and sometimes we have to ignore something. That is understanding. We know the weakness of somebody or the other. And then we are able to get along with somebody. That is adjustment. Okay? So there age has nothing to do with it. Some people are not able to manage, adjust with anyone even at the age of 90. And some people are able to manage with the others even when they are 3 years old. You might have seen some children, you send them to their grandparents, to their uncles, to their parents. They are happy everywhere. And you send somebody who is 30 years to one another family, they say, no, I can't adjust there. I can't live for one day there. So it is of all wisdom, right? So, okay, here he says that, let's say I married a very young girl. Now he's giving an example, Ranga. Let's say I married a very young girl. She may take my words spoken in love as words of spoken in anger. So he says that if I say something, maybe that girl will not be able to understand me. Recently, a troupe in Bangalore staged the play Shakuntala. There is no question of Dushyanta falling in love with Shakuntala if she were young, like the present day brides. Is there? So you might have also heard about a play, Shakuntala, written by Kalidas. Kalidas is called as the Shakespeare of India. Okay, so, Shakespeare of Sanskrit. Kalidasa is one of the best, playwright. He wrote plays in Sanskrit. But now because Sanskrit has become, obsolete language, so nobody even knows who Kalidas was. But if you read Kalidas, you will say like he was far, far better than Shakespeare also. Shakespeare, everybody knows. But Kalidas, even in India, our students don't know. Because it's our own mistake. Okay? But anyways, the point over here is, the writer, Ranga, says that Shakuntala is a play where there is a story of Dushyant and Shakuntala. Okay? Dushyant falls in love with Shakuntala and all. So he says that if the present day brides are like Shakuntala, then there might not ever be a story of love story between Dushyant and Shakuntala if it were present times. There is no question of Dushyant falling in love with Shakuntala if she were young, like the present day brides. Is there? So what is the like fact about the present day brides? They are restless. They are impatient. They are short tempered. They are unskilled, basically. Okay, nowadays the brides are, I am not talking about feminism or anti-feminism. Nowadays, earlier, whenever the marriages used to be there, everybody used to be skilled. Even the boy would be able to do something and the girls used to be very skilled. Now the thing is nobody knows anything. And in the end, there are disputes. And then the point comes like they are not able to adjust anywhere. The point is lack of skill. Now the children are only doing the things which is academics. Life doesn't run on academics. You cannot eat degrees at night. While dinner, you'll have to eat something. And for that, you'll have to cook something. And each time, you won't have your servants at your, place each time. The servants might go for a leave. So you should know something or the other. So the present day brides are unskilled, basically. Not many people know this. So the point is, it's not about brides. It's about even boys also. They are equally unskilled. Kuch nahi aata, chai banani nahi aati boys ko. Hai na? I'm not. Huh? Okay, that's great. No, we are talking about ki like skills, one should be skilled. Maybe boys, maybe girls. Okay, there is no question of. So, what would have happened to Kalidasa's play? Look there. So if one gets married, it should be to a girl who is mature. Otherwise, one should remain a bachelor. That is why I'm not marrying now, Ranga says. Is there any other reason? Narrator is asking. Narrator, she says, like, any other reason, like, you don't want to marry? Narrator says, let's see. A man should marry a girl he admires. Narrator actually is very wise. You people might have also seen that if the parents ask the child, like, beta, now you should get married off. And the child says, no, I will not marry yet. The parents straightway come to the point, have you seen somebody? This is what the narrator is actually asking. Like anything else in your mind? Got it? And narrator is going to point out, like, he has not selected anyone so far, but yes, he will be marrying a girl of his choice. So he will be, in a way, rejecting the idea of arranged marriage. But one thing is here that he has not yet selected any girl, but he will plan to marry a girl of his choice. Narrator is very smart. So he will plan to make narrator fall in love with the girl whom he wants him to marry. See his smartness. Getting? So far, the narrator, Ranga, has not fallen in love with anyone. And narrator will make him fall in love with the girl whom he wants him to marry. See the smartness of narrator. So a man should marry a girl he admires. What we have now are arranged marriages. How can one admire a girl with milk stains on one side of her face and wetness on the other, or so young that she doesn't even know how to bite her fingers? So the point is that why, how can one marry an immature girl who is so young in age? Okay, the one who doesn't even know how to do makeup. How can you marry that kind of immature girl, he says. One a neem fruit, the other a bitter gourd. Understand? Yes. So exactly, Ranga said laughing. So Ranga said, yes, you are very right. I was distressed that the boy who I thought would make a good husband had decided to remain a bachelor. So what was narrator's reaction when he got to know that narrator didn't want to marry? He was distressed. He was sad. Yes, the narrator was sad on knowing that that Ranga didn't want to marry yet. Why was he sad? Because he thought that Ranga would be such a good husband. But how can he become a good husband when he doesn't even want to marry? Okay, after chatting for a longer, Ranga left. I made up my mind right then that I would get him married. Got it? Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11, had come to stay with him. She was born. She was from a big town, so she knew how to play the veena and the harmonium. Minded children, narrate, Ranga had told us that he would not marry an immature girl. The one who would be so kiddish, he wanted to say. And what's the age of the girl? Narrator is planning 11. And you will see that he will marry her. Point is what thing elders think and plan, that is always, you know, fine. Yeah, this story has been written with the background where marriage age was not fixed. Earlier people used to marry like this. Okay, aage dekhiye. So she also had a sweet voice. Both her parents had died and her uncle had brought her home. Ranga was just the boy for her. So Ranga was just the boy for her, and she the most suitable bride for him. So narrator wanted that Ranga should marry Ratna, the one who was 11 year old, the one whose parents had already expired, the one who was now living with her uncle. Okay, see this, just a minute children, it's very important for you people to see. The point is, yeah, she had come to stay with him. She was Ranga Rao's niece, number one. She was from a big town. See narrator's planning. It's not that he was getting this boy married with any girl. He knew that she had come from a big city. Ranga had also come from city. Number one match he's making. A compatibility he has already seen. Number one, she's from a big city. So she knew how to play the veena and harmonium. Secondly, she is skilled, talented. She knew how to play veena and harmonium. She also had a sweet voice. Just a minute. Yes, sorry for disruption, children. No, for you again. So her parents had died, and her uncle had brought her home. Ranga was just the boy for her, and she the most suitable bride for him. So the girl was equally good. If Ranga was a gem, then the girl was equally diamond. Okay, the meaning is the match was very compatible. If Ranga was a very graceful, intelligent, independent boy, then Ranga was a after this class. Ranga was just the boy for her, and she the most suitable bride for him. Since I was a frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, look at the text. Since I was a frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, the girl was quite free with me. So because he used to go to Rama Rao's place every now and then, so Ratna knew narrator very well. So she was very frank with her. Okay, she was well acquainted with the narrator. Got it? The girl was quite free with me. I completely forgot to mention her name, Ratna. It was. The very next morning, I went to their house and told Rama Rao's wife, I'll send some buttermilk for you. Ask Ratna to fetch it. So next morning, the narrator went to Rama Rao's house and he told his wife that today I will send some lassi for you. You please send Ratna to my house. So narrator is inviting Ratna to his house. Actually, he has made up his mind to make Ratna see Ranga and Ranga see Ratna. Got it? Ratna came. It was a Friday, so she was wearing a grand sari. I told her to sit in my room and requested her to sing a song. So it was a Friday, which is considered very auspicious in India. So she was wearing a grand sari on Friday, and when she came, the narrator asked her to sing. Got it? I sent for Ranga. He even called Ranga. While she was singing the song, Krishnamurti, in front of my eyes, Ranga reached the door. Krishnamurti in front of my eyes. So when she was singing the song, in front of my eyes, find out please. So Ranga reached the door. Ranga came over there. When she was singing, then Ranga came. So Ranga will also listen to the song. He stopped at the threshold, that is entrance. He did not want the singing to stop, but was curious to see the singer. Carefully, he peeped in. The light coming into the room was blocked. Ratna looked up and seeing a stranger there, abruptly stopped. So when Ratna was singing, then Ranga also heard the song. Then he wanted to see who the singer was. So he peeped inside, and Ratna came to know that somebody has come. So she stopped singing. Suppose you buy the best quality mango. So here you can read it all on your own. Then the point over here is like when Ranga was listening to the song, but it stopped, then he was disturbed. When you're enjoying something and that enjoyment is curtailed in between, then you don't like it. So similar was the condition of this Ranga at this time. Okay. Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. So Ratna, when she saw that Ranga had come, she was very shy and she went off. So the girls at this age, they are not very comfortable because, okay, after a while, Ranga asked, who is that girl? Okay. So up till this page, children, be ready for the test next week. Up till page number 20. Send me the attendance. Riddhi, send me the screenshot. Yes, madam.